Hello and welcome back to Space Engineers on the Xbox on the Series X for this short tutorial on something that I've wanted to do for a while and to correct a few errors in a previous video where I talked about Supergridding. Yeah, it's that elephant in the room, or Imperial Star Destroyer in the void. To begin with, the Xbox cannot actually do Supergridding out of the gate. You need a PC. What Supergridding is the ability to place different size blocks on a different size grid. For instance, small grid blocks on a large grid ship. Different to hybrid gridding, which is what we've decided to call what I'm going to show you in this video. Now, if you're new to Space Engineers, this is a great place to jump in when you're trying to learn to place different sized grids and create hybrid grids, where you have a large grid ship, but there's small grid blocks, maybe for a lift or something like that, on the ship itself. But a supergrid actually requires the editing of a file, a .sbc file, to change the type of block so that you can place these small grid blocks on the large grid ship. And to do that, as I said, you need a PC. But you also need support for supergridding. Now, on the Xbox, we do have support for supergridding. If you go into your load game, and we'll pick one of my saved games here, my drill rig test, press X to edit the settings, and then pop down with Y to advanced, and you'll see all these settings. Ignore everything for now. I've gone through the settings millions of times. Well, not millions. Several times in various videos, including my new game, new player tutorials. And you'll see here, you can see various different settings. In amongst all these settings, you'll see one called Enable Supergridding. Now, with Enable Supergridding on, you'll be able to basically download on the workshop, on mod.io, any blueprint that has a supergrid built into it, and it will work. This is not hybrid gridding, though. As I said, you require a PC, and you need to edit a file to be able to do it. So we can't do true supergridding on the Xbox. All we can do is hybrid grids. And a hybrid grid, well, a hybrid grid, if we load up my drill rig test game, is pretty much what I've been doing for the last 130 or whatever videos. Whenever I build a small grid ship off a large grid base, I am technically using a hybrid grid. Let's just nip over here into one of my little areas, and let's pop open the build menu. Let's select our light armor block, and then let's just place some blocks down, as we always do. We don't need to make this any kind of fancy. We just need a large grid. Upon this large grid, we place one rotor, like so. And on this rotor, you can also place, for ease of use, a control terminal. Like so. Now, if you're playing in survival, you'll need to grind that part off and then activate the control terminal, go into your rotor, do two things. One, for now, turn the rotor lock on, and then add a small head. Like so. Now you'll see that large rotor has a small head on it. From this small head, we can now place small grid blocks. Like so. And if you're building, say, like a lift, you can use this to get a really nice flush lift in the space allotted, rather than using these great big large grid clunky blocks. And because of the way Space Engineers handles collisions, you're not going to have to worry about those blocks pushing against each other anymore. It used to be a case that things like that wouldn't work, but now we've got the collision isn't as vicious. We can do a lot more with secret doors and sliding platforms against each other and so on. But that is how to build on a small, or rather a large grid with a small grid, a hybrid grid. So if you look at this here, you'll see your rotor. If we add, say, another rotor to this, a small tiny rotor, come back here, you'll see that rotor is a different color. That's because it's what's known as a subgrid, and grids are divided into grids, subgrids, and a hybrid grid just creates a different sized subgrid. So one great idea on this is, what if you wanted to get a large grid ore detector on a small grid ship? Well, this is a little trickier because it requires you to fiddle about with placing a large grid head onto a small grid rotor. And if you remember from looking at this, there we go, grid, if we look at the rotor here, a subgrid rotor, and again, if we lock it, we cannot add large grid head. We can only add a rotor head, which will be a small head. And getting one of these large grid heads onto this thing is a little bit of a dance. And my recommendation is, if you're playing in creative mode, you probably want to hold both bumpers down, press X, and quick save. Now bear in mind that the A button will maneuver yourself. And what you want to try and do is you want to try and orientate yourself just as roughly as you can over the top of this thing. And then you want to go to your rotors and you want to cycle through, and you'll see various things. And you'll see rotor part. And you want the large grid. But if you notice, as I'm moving about, the rotor part itself kind of fits over the top of the grid. But if it touches a large grid block, it becomes large grid. And you want to try and get yourself as close as possible over the top. And the way the thrusters in Space Engineers work, it takes a little bit of doing. And then when you're like this, you want to try and not move. And then hold down the left bumper and just keep tapping the D-pad. You'll see now that you can change the size of the rotor part. So to do that, hold down the left bumper and tap X. Orientate the rotor part over the top of the rotor, and this is the bit where it requires a little bit of fiddling. So first of all, if you find it's still a small grid part, push up on the D-pad, cycle through until you get to rotor part. And if it's still small grid, just hold down the left bumper, tap X, and it will change it from small to large. When you think you've got it in the right place, both bumpers X and save. Now, again, it's moved out of its sort of thing, so that hasn't quite worked. Again, it's trial and error, and it is a royal, royal pain to do. But if you can get it right, so if you just paste it, let it drop, you'll see that if you're over the top of the rotor in the right place, it'll perform a weird little rotating dance like this, and if you get it wrong, it falls off. Again, it is a bit of trial and error, but this is what Space Engineers is about when you're trying to do these kind of things. So what you can do here is basically nothing except delete that rotor part and try again. What we could do to make it possibly easier, I need to reset the distance on that, is just provide a little bit more stability around this platform. And again, put ourselves in the right place, get ourselves our rotor part, pull it back off the grid for now, rotate it until it's there, change the grid size, pull back up, let it drop, let it do the dance. That should be in the right place. Come down here, go to our rotor, click attach, and we have a small grid with our large block, like I said, functionality. We can add an ore detector, like so, onto a small grid. Like I said, it does require a little bit of fiddling. You'll get used to it though if you play around with it. And that is hybrid gridding, both large grid to small and small grid to large. Not an easy thing to do, and there are probably other easier ways to do it, or ways that require you to sort of build blocks up past the rotor and then put the thing over the top and drop it. But I find you can probably get it easier if you align the small head, then change the size and pull it up until you're ready to drop it. As long as it drops directly down and starts wobbling around the rotor, and you can get to your control panel, quickly change it to attach head, and you'll be able to attach your rotor head and have a hybrid grid. As I said before at the start of this video, this is not Supergridding. The Xbox cannot do Supergridding. Neither can the PlayStation. Let's include the PlayStation in this, because the chances are, if you're watching, then you may have come from the PlayStation version, in which case it's the same thing. You require a PC, you need to edit what's called an SBC file, and you need to change parameters in that to allow the blocks to fit together. But we can only support Supergridding on our consoles. We can't do it from the console itself. It's the same as scripting. We cannot script from a PlayStation or an Xbox. We require the use of a PC to create a script. And again, with servers, we can't use any scripts, barring the ones that are vanilla to the game, in a solo or hosted multiplayer game. We can only use server-side scripts on a dedicated server, and these are servers you either run off a PC that can run the Space Engineers client as a server with EOS compatibility for both Xbox and PlayStation, or you go to a server provider, you pay per month, and you buy a dedicated server or rent a dedicated server. And that's it. That is your quick look for just over 15 minutes or so at hybrid gridding. I reiterate, not super gridding. I made that mistake a way back, and people let me know in the comments how wrong I was, because that's what the internet's good for, letting you know how wrong you are, usually in the rudest way possible. So far, though, I found the community around the game to be reasonably good, and certainly the community I have over on Facebook for the Xbox console community. And we are thinking potentially of just becoming a console community. Now we have the PlayStation beta running in the game, so we'll see. We're thinking about that at the moment. It's not just a case of being able to do it, because we have a group to consider. Anyway, that's enough from me. That's hybrid gridding. Stay safe, take care, have fun, enjoy the game. Loads more to come from me. Loads more to come from Keen Software down the line. I will catch you in the next one, and I'll be looking at another kind of drone. The drone that could light your base and just wander around using just a few blocks and a very simple setting on these new automatons AI blocks that were released recently. See you. Bye.